So, Paul, in the previous video, we talked about what questions employers should ask before hiring. So now I want to ask you, how can a job seeker be prepared to answering interview questions? We know that most of the time there are behavioral questions. So how can they use the technique of storytelling to tell their story to a potential employer?
It's a great question. The storytelling piece is important because it lets an employer know who you are and what's important to you. And I think that too many times candidates are so nervous, or they think that they have to come across as like perfect in an interview. And the answer is you don't. As an employer myself, I see managers that get very nervous and they think they have to come across as management. And it's like, just relax and have a little fun. Now, not everybody has that same style, and that's okay. But the reality to me, Meher, becomes when someone says to me, Paul, what's your greatest weakness? That's always a question you're going to get. Or what's an area of development that you need to work on? A lot of candidates know the trick, right? You say you give a weakness, but it's really a strength. A weakness taken to an extreme is a, or I should say a strength taken to an extreme, they're calling it a weakness. Oh, you know, I'm too loyal. I'm too dedicated. I work too many hours. It's kind of silly. As an employer, the truth of the matter is I do want to know what's your self-assessment. And if someone were to ask me that question, I would tell them, I'm not a perfect human being. My feelings can get hurt. I tend to have a thinner skin. I'm not someone who, you know, I always strive to please. I was always the kid who brought the teacher the apple. I'm not someone who, I take constructive criticism well, but if it's not so constructive, it doesn't work well with me. So just so you know, that's not one of my strengths. It's not an area that, oh, Paul Falcone and his thick skin, you can, you know, throw a lamp at him. It's not a problem. That doesn't work with me. And I try and make them laugh. And I've always done that in my interview because I want them to see the humanity in it. The funny thing is, as a candidate, because Lord knows I've had to be a candidate just like I've had to be an employer, a lot of times the interviewers are so uncomfortable. They don't know what to ask. The reason I wrote the book, The 96 Great Interview Questions, was to give critical mass to the interviewer. They need, you know, people interview for 10 and 15 minutes, and then they come back to my offices in human resources and they say, I love the candidate. And I say, did you even let the person sit down? You were only there for 10 minutes. I mean, what did you ask? They need to know the kinds of questions to ask, but a candidate needs to be smart too. The candidate needs to know that if the employer is uncomfortable, there's a way that you can weave your story to make them comfortable, do the eye contact, do the body language, and make sure that they can understand your point of view. So I just say, relax a little bit, lighten up, just be you. There's no perfect candidate, there's no perfect job. But what you're hoping to do is establish a professional relationship, but also to a degree, a personal relationship with the person who's the gatekeeper into that company.
And interviewing is a two-way communication. You are interviewing also the employer, and the employee is also interviewing you. So you need to have that open communication and be yourself and be your authentic self while you're being interviewed.
Very good. Yeah, authentic self. I would agree with that. Very good.